See his head, a peacock feather is there, curling hairs are there, and how he's holding flute, how his three places carved, Tribhanga Dhamma, and from his lotus feet, Amya, Amrut, nectar is emanating, and he has put a nupur on his lotus feet, produces tinkling sound, vun, jun, vun, jun. Oh, I want to see constantly such beautiful form of Krishna. I want to assume the form of a bumblebee. Yeah, I want to assume the form of a bumblebee and always hovering there at the lotus feet of Krishna. The bumblebee hovers around lotus. Always I want to assume the form of a bumblebee and hover around there at the lotus feet of Krishna. Then it will be so easy for me. I'll be completely absorbed in that thought of Krishna and completely absorbed in that ocean of nectar emanating from the lotus feet of Krishna. And really, it's that nectar, that mellow. Oh, Sakhi, I don't want anything. I'll always sing those good qualities of Krishna. Always I want to engage in Krishna bhajan, no other bhajan. Understand? This is what? This is rupa sravana. You understand? To hear about the beautiful form of the Lord. That stage will come next. Then, when you hear about the beautiful form of the Lord, Krishna, then you will acquire the qualification how that form will rise in your heart. Understand? Always. In this way, hearing such things, hearing about rupa, beautiful form, always hearing from the lips of Guru, then guna-spurti, then transcendent qualities will arise. Do you understand? When transcendent qualities will arise, then you can see the whole beautiful leelas, braja-leela of Krishna. Such vision, you will be endowed with such vision. Wherever you look, at the beautiful form of Krishna, not only form, how he is engaged in braja-leela. Such nice pastimes. Braja-bhumi, you the themselves of braja-bhumi. Do you understand? That you can also see. So, these are different types of hearing and these are chronological order of hearing. In this way, of all sorts of hearing, Srimad Bhagavatam Sravana Parvasespa, the Srimad Bhagavatam Sravana is the topmost hearing. Do you understand? This Jiva Goswami has mentioned in Krama Sandarbha. All right? Then, what is the glory of hearing? What result you will have? Hearing such is the second canto, 2-3-7. Pibanti je bhagavatatmana sadam kathamrutam sravanapute susambhudam punanti te visaya vidusitasayam vradanti tatsarana saroruhantikam. 2-2-37.
Those who drink through oral reception, fully filled with the nectarian message of Lord Krishna, the beloved of the devotees, purify the polluted aim of life known as material enjoyment, and thus go back to Godhead, to the lotus feet of Him, the personality of Godhead. Those who drink through oral reception, fully filled with the nectarian message of Lord Krishna, the beloved of the devotees, they purify the polluted aim of life known as material enjoyment, and thus go back to Godhead.
Thus go back to Godhead. Then?
To the lotus feet of Him, the personality of Godhead. They thus go back to Godhead, to the lotus feet of Him, the personality of Godhead.
Back to Godhead means back to the lotus feet of Godhead, huh? Isn't it? Yes. Only by hearing you can go. Without hearing, I can go. By hearing, your self-vision will move. You'll be endowed with self-vision. Then you can see. Sute Gita Padam. You understand? And you have to hear first, then eyes will be open. You'll be endowed with self-vision, then you can see all beautiful form of Krishna and all lilas of Krishna. Otherwise, you can't. Understand? Huh? 284. Śrāṇāta sahya nityaṁ grāṣṭhāśca sosyaṣṭhitaṁ nāti dṛgyena kālena bhagavān viṣadhe kṛdi.
Persons who hear Shrimad Bhagavatam regularly and are always taking the matter very seriously will have the personality of Godhead, Sri Krishna, manifested in their hearts within a short time.
Manifests his heart in a very short time. Without hearing, it will never take place. Hearing is most important. Understand? Hearing from the lips of a pure sadhu, sadhu, guru, Vaishnava, premi, bhakta is most important thing. Isn't it? And this purport says, same thing, hearing. Jnana prayasa udapasya namanta eva jivanti samugaritam bhavadiya vartam tane sthita sudigatam tanubang manovir jo prayasa adito jito pesista istilokyam. This verse Prabhupada has quoted, half of the verse, 10.4.14.3. You have that verse?
Those who, even while remaining situated in their established social positions, throw away the process of speculative knowledge.
Throw away the process of speculative knowledge. Only here. Don't speculate.
And with their body, words, and mind, offer all respects to descriptions of your personality and activities.
Brahma, this is Brahma's prayer to Lord. Yes.
Dedicating their lives to these narrations, which are vibrated by you personally and by your pure devotees, certainly conquer your lordship, although you are otherwise unconquerable by anyone within the three worlds.
Yes. If he hears attentively, putting firm faith from pure sadhu, your katha, we are able to conquer you, who is unconquerable. Unconquerable in three worlds will conquer. Do you understand? Don't you want it? Then, how serious you are. That is test for you. Only nodding head, externally, or serious. What?
Not serious.
Not serious. Well, get out from here. Be serious. This is for serious students. Prabhupada says repeatedly. This is for serious students, not superfluous. Be serious. Give up superfluousness. You understand? Take a bow. Take a bow. I must take it up seriously. Alright? You understand? No more attraction towards Maya. Only your pure Krishna katha from the lips of sadhu, this medicine, then the cure of this heart disease lost. Understand?